بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد عليه وعلى آله أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم. أما بعد، اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم زدنا علما نافعا وعملا صالحا متقبلا يا رب العالمين.
الشيخ عبد الرحمن مواسي، in this evening, the 16th or is it the 18th of the Qa'dah 1443, he starts by praising Allah and sending a salat and salam upon the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and then he made dua asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to teach us beneficial knowledge and make us benefit from the knowledge that we have gained. And he made some other nice du'as as well.
جزا الله خيرا من تسبب في هذا اللقاء وفي هذا الجمع الطيب.
May Allah reward the whoever was a means and a cause of bringing this gathering together.
وأسأل الله أن يكون في موازين حسناتهم.
And may Allah place it in his good deeds.
وثالثا يعني أنا ليس عندي شيء حتى أقدمه لكم، بل منكم من هو عنده العلم أكثر مني.
Thirdly, the Sheikh says, I actually don't have anything to offer you which is new, and some of you have more knowledge than I have.
وهذا الكلام ليس تواضعا، لا يفهم أنه تواضع، لا هذا حقيقة.
I'm not just being modest, the Sheikh says, but this is the reality.
وقد حضرنا من أجل أن نستفيد. أيضا الشيخ وليد قد تكون له كلمة فتأخر.
The Sheikh says that I attended in order to benefit, as Sheikh Waleed was going to be here and also to give us a reminder, but he is slightly delayed.
فقلنا نتذاكر فيما بعد فيما بعض لبعض الأمور، وقد لا نطيل في هذه الكلمة إلى أن يحضر الشيخ جزاه الله خير.
So the Sheikh says on that basis we decided that maybe we will just sit together and do some revision together, revise some points of benefit together until the Sheikh arrives.
ولعلي لا أطيل عليكم، لكن سأتكلم في ثلاثة أمور أو ثلاثة أو اثنين إن شاء الله.
The Sheikh says, I don't want to prolong it, but I will speak about two or three points, inshallah.
فأولا قد نتكلم عن الإخلاص لطالب العلم.
Firstly, the Sheikh said we should speak about a student of knowledge being sincere.
فالإخلاص هو من أهم الأعمال التي ينبغي للمسلم أو أن يهتم بها المسلم.
The sincerity is from the most important actions that every Muslim must take care of.
وليس الإخلاص بالكلام، ليس الإخلاص بالقول.
Sincerity is not just a statement of the tongue.
إنما بالفعل.
Rather, it's by actions.
وقد ذكر العز بن عبد السلام.
And العز ابن عبد السلام mentioned.
في بعض كلامه.
In some of his statements.
قال الإخلاص.
He said sincerity is.
أن تعمل الطاعة لله خالصة لله عز وجل.
That you do an act of obedience purely for the sake of Allah, the Mighty and Majestic.
لا تريد تعظيما من الناس ولا توقيرا.
You're not expecting to be respected or honored by the people.
ولا جلب نفع ديني.
And you're not trying to gain any religious benefit.
ولا دفع ضرر دنيوي.
Or trying to repel any worldly harm.
نعم، لأن الإنسان إذا أراد أن يعبد الله عز وجل أو أن يتقرب إلى الله عز وجل فيكون العمل خالصا لوجه الله عز وجل.
The Sheikh says this is the reality, because when a person wants to do an act of worship, he has to do it purely for the sake of Allah عز وجل.
فإن الصحابة.
For indeed the companions.
ما رفعهم الله عز وجل هذه الرفعة.
Allah سبحانه وتعالى didn't raise them to the level that He raised them.
إلا بصدق الإخلاص.
Except after they were truthful to and purely sincere.
بل إن بعض السلف.
Rather, some of the pious predecessors.
من قوة إخلاصه لله عز وجل.
Due to the strength of their sincerity.
كان إذا دخل عليه أحد وهو يقرأ القرآن.
They were such that if somebody entered the room while they were reading Quran.
غطاه حتى لا يروه الناس.
They would cover the Quran or hide it so the people were not able to see what he was doing.
بل إن بعض السلف أيضا
rather some of the Salaf also
عندما زارت الامرأة إلى زوجة أحد العباد من السلف
when they would have one of their wives would receive a visitor
فكانت الأرض مبلولة
and the ground was wet
فقالت إن الصبي قد بال في هذا المكان
and so he would make an excuse and say it's wet because a child urinated in this place
فقيل إن هذا فلان يبيت يقوم الليل ويبكي
but it was rather it was the tears of so and so who would stand in the night prayer crying
بل إن بعضهم
rather some of them
قد يكون على سريره مع زوجته
would possibly be on his bed next to his wife
ويبكي من خشية الله
and he would cry out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala
ولا تعرف عنه
and his wife would not even have noticed that
فهذا هو سبب لرفعة الله عز وجل لهؤلاء القوم
and this is the reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised these people in station
وذكر ابن منظور في لسان العرب
And Ibn al-Manzoor mentions in his book Lisan al-Arab
قال سميت سورة الإخلاص بهذا الاسم
He said that سورة الإخلاص was called this name
لأنها
because
اتصفت بالإخلاص في صفة الله عز وجل
هذه شوف
أنها تصف صفات الله عز وجل
This surah was called Surah Al-Ikhlas because it describes the attributes of Allah Azza wa Jal.
فمن حققها فقد حقق التوحيد لله عز وجل.
So whoever actualizes that surah, he actualizes the tawheed of Allah Azza wa Jal by singling him out in worship.
فالإخلاص هو حقيقة الدين.
So sincerity is the reality of the deen of Islam.
ودعوة الرسل.
And it is the call of all of the messengers عليهم الصلاة والسلام.
وما أمروا إلا ليعبدوا الله مخلصين له الدين حنفاء.
As Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, وما أمروا إلا ليعبدوا الله مخلصين له الدين حنفاء. And they were not commanded with anything rather than else than to.
وكذلك.
Than to worship Allah. عفوا شيخ. ترجم الآية ترجم معنى الآية and they were commanded with none other than to make their acts of worship sincerely for Allah making their لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ to worship Allah مُخْلِصِينَ sincerely making the religion purely for him حُنَفَى swerving away from shirk is that correct?
فهذه هي دعوة الرسل.
So this was the call of the messengers.
فهم دعوا إلى التوحيد.
They called the people to توحيد.
ودعوا إلى الإخلاص لله عز وجل.
And to the sincerity of worship of Allah عز وجل.
والله عز وجل خلق الجنة والنار من أجل التوحيد.
And Allah عز وجل created paradise and hellfire because of the توحيد.
وأرسل الرسل من أجل التوحيد.
And for that purpose and for that reason he sent the messengers.
بل إن الصحابة كان الرجل يقتل أباه أو يقتل ابنه من أجل التوحيد.
Rather the Sahaba, one of them would possibly kill his own father or his own son because of التوحيد.
وكذلك في قول الله عز وجل هو الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا.
And this ayah that the Sheikh just mentioned ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا to test you which of you is best in action
فقد قال الفضيل بن عياض رحمه الله
الفضيل بن عياض said
قال أخلصه وأصوبه أحسن عملا أي أخلصه وأصوبه
the best action means the most sincere and the most correct
قيل يا أبا علي ما أخلصه وأصوبه
He was asked, what is the meaning of the most sincere and the most correct action?
قال إن كان صائبا ولم يكن إن كان خالصا ولم يكن صوابا لم يقبل.
He said that if an action is sincere but not correct, it's not going to be accepted.
وإن كان صوابا ولم يكن خالصا لم يقبل.
And if it is a correct action but not sincere, it will not be accepted.
فلا بد أن يكون خالصا صوابا.
Until it is correct and sincere.
خالصا لله عز وجل.
Purely for the sake of Allah, the Mighty and Majestic.
صوابا على السنة.
Correct meaning upon the Sunnah.
فلهذا.
And for this reason.
الإخلاص كما ذكرت في بداية الكلمة أنه عظيم لابد الإنسان أن يجاهد نفسه في هذا الأمر.
As we mentioned at the beginning, the Sheikh says the status of sincerity is great and a person has to strive and struggle to fulfill this aspect of his deen.
بل إن السلف كانوا يجاهدون أنفسهم على الإخلاص.
Rather the earliest Muslims, the pious predecessors, they would strive and struggle against themselves in order to actualize and to fulfill al-ikhlas or sincerity.
وقد ورد عن بعضهم أنه قال,
and it was reported from some of them that they said,
أشد أو كما قال أشد علي أو ما جاهدت شيئا أشد علي من نيتي.
There was nothing that was more difficult for me to strive against than my own intentions.
إنها تتقلب علي.
For they turn and change against me.
وهذا الأثر لعله عن سفيان إن لم أكن واهم.
And the Sheikh says, I think this is a narration narrated from Sufyan, if my memory serves me correct.
وكذلك قال بعض أهل العلم أيضا أو من السلف أيضا.
And some of the Salaf also said,
طلبنا العلم لغير الله.
We sought knowledge for other than Allah's sake.
فأبى إلا أن يكون لله.
And it refused except to be for the sake of Allah.
هذا هو العلم لأن العلم قال الله قال الرسول قال الصحابة.
And this is the nature of knowledge because knowledge is that which Allah said, that which the Messenger said, and that which the Sahaba said.
فلهذا العلم يربي.
So knowledge nurtures a person.
فينبغي على طالب العلم أن يحرص على العلم.
So therefore a student of knowledge must be keen to seek knowledge.
بل إن بعض أهل العلم
rather some of the people of knowledge
ذكر في بعض آداب المعلم الطالب والمعلم
they mentioned some of the manners of the teacher and the student
قال على المعلم
they said it's upon the teacher
أن يعلم الطالب
to teach his student
حتى لو رأى أنه يطلب العلم لغير الله
even if he felt that he is seeking knowledge for other than Allah's sake.
لأن العلم سيربي.
Because knowledge will nurture that individual.
فينبغي للمسلم.
So it is befitting for the Muslim.
أن يجاهد نفسه للإخلاص.
That he strives and struggles against himself to fulfill and to actualize being sincere for Allah the Mighty and Majestic.
وذكر شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله
and ابن تيمية رحمه الله mentioned
تعليقا طيبا
a good point of benefit here
على ثلاثة أحاديث
based on three hadiths
منها حديث البطاقة
from them is the hadith of the parchment known as the hadith البطاقة
التي فيها قول لا إله إلا الله
that parchment that has لا إله إلا الله written in it
فإنه قال رحمه الله
He said, may Allah have mercy upon him about this hadith.
فَإِنَّ هَذَا قَالَهَا مِنْ قَلْبِي خَالِصًا لِلَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ
That individual who is mentioned in the hadith of the parchment, he said لا إله إلا الله purely from his heart.
لِأَنَّ هُنَاكَ غَيْرَهُ
Because others besides him,
مِنْ أَهْلِ الْمَعَاصِي وَالْكَبَائِرِ
those who were engaged in sins and major sins,
مِمَّنْ قَالَهَا
From those who said this statement,
وَلَكِنَّهُ أُدْخِلَ إِلَى النَّارِ
Yet he was entered into the hellfire.
فَلَمْ يَقُولُوهَا كَمَا قَالَ هَذَا خَالِصَةً لِلَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ
Those people, they didn't make that statement of La ilaha illallah like this person said it.
وَكَذَلِكَ عَلَى حَدِيثِ الْمَرْأَةِ الَّتِي سَقَتِ الْكَلْبَ الْمَرْأَةَ الْبَغِيِّ
Like this person said it in terms of sincerity. The Sheikh says also the second hadith was the woman who, the prostitute who had given water to a dog.
فذكر شيخ الإسلام قال أنها سقته بإخلاص.
Ibn Taymiyyah mentioned, rahimahullah, that she gave water to that dog to quench its thirst sincerely for Allah's sake.
فمن أجل ذلك غفر لها.
And due to that sincerity, she was forgiven her sins.
وكذلك الرجل الذي نحى الشوكة عن طريق المسلمين عن طريق الناس.
And the third hadith that he mentioned was that individual, that man who moved a thorn from the path of the people.
فهذا إنما أبعده أيضا العمل مخلصا لله عز وجل.
He did that purely for the sake of Allah عز وجل.
فينبغي على المسلم.
عفوا يا شيخ هذا الحديث الثالث.
الذي
نحى. أيوة ما هو الحديث؟
الرجل الذي نحى الشوكة عن طريق الناس فغفر الله له.
That Allah سبحانه وتعالى forgave that individual who had removed that thorn from the path. Allah Ta'ala forgave him because of the sin, that he did that action purely and sincerely for Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala.
فمن هذا الكلام ينبغي للمسلم أن يخلص جميع أعماله لمن لله عز وجل.
So the Sheikh says, in summary, it is upon every one of us to make all of his actions and statements purely for the sake of who? Of Allah Azza wa Jal.
كذلك تعلمون في بعض الأحاديث التي ذكرت من أوائل من يسعر بهم النار.
The Sheikh says that also you would have heard those hadiths. For example, the first people that will be thrown into the fire. The Sheikh pauses to ask you who they are.
قارئ القرآن.
The first of them is the one who recited the Quran.
يقال له لما قرأت القرآن.
It will be said to him, why did you recite the Quran?
فيقول قرأته فيك يا الله.
He will say, I read it for your sake, O Allah.
فيقال له كذبت إنما قرأت ليقال قارئ.
And it will be said to him, you lied. You read the Quran so that people could say that you are a reciter.
فلهذا ينبغي علينا أن نحرص على الإخلاص.
So for that reason, we have to be very careful about the issue of al-ikhlas or sincerity.
وأن نجعل أعمالنا خالصة لله عز وجل لا نقدمها للناس.
And that we make our actions purely and sincerely for Allah, and we don't do them to present them to people.
نسأل الله أن يجعلنا ممن يخلصون لله عز وجل.
We ask Allah to make us from those people who make their actions pure and sincere for Allah's sake alone.
النقطة الثانية.
The second point.
ونقف عليها لأن الشيخ جاء الشيخ وليد.
The Sheikh said we'll suffice with the second point because the Sheikh is here.
فالنقطة الثانية لعلي أتكلم على اختيار الأصحاب.
The second point.
الصالحة.
The second point the Sheikh says I'd like to talk about is choosing your companions and your friends well, meaning righteous companions.
فإن اختيار الأصحاب هذه من صفات المؤمنين الأبرار.
For choosing good companions is from the qualities of righteous people.
فمن طبع الإنسان.
Naturally, a person.
لا بد أن يجالس الناس.
Has to sit with people and mix with people.
فلا بد أن يختار له الصديق الصالح.
So he has to choose a righteous companion. Or a friend.
الذي يعينه في الدنيا والآخرة.
Who will aid him and help him in this life and in the hereafter, matters of the hereafter.
فإذا أردت أن تختار صاحبا وصديقا.
So when you want to choose a friend.
فانظر إلى حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Then look at the hadith of the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم.
لا تصاحب إلا مؤمنا إلا مؤمن.
He said, do not accompany anyone other than a believer.
ولا يأكل طعامك إلا تقي.
And do not let anyone share your food with you except that one who is pious or righteous.
نعم لماذا لماذا.
Why the Sheikh says.
لأنك عندما تصاحب المؤمن.
Because when you accompany the believer.
عندما تصاحب صاحب السنة.
And when you accompany the person who is upon the sunnah.
عندما تصاحب السلفي الذي معك على المنهج.
And when you accompany that person who is in conformity to the manhaj, to the way of the salaf,
فإنه يعينك على الطاعة.
He will encourage you and aid you to remain obedient to Allah.
وإذا رآك على خطأ,
and when he, if he was to see you upon error,
نصحك,
he would advise you.
وإذا رآك في ضعف,
and if he saw you weakening,
حاول أن يقف معك,
he would try to stand with you and support you.
فهذا هو المؤمن.
This is the way of the believer.
ولا يأكل طعامك إلا تقي.
And let not anyone other than a pious person share your food with you.
لأن التقي,
because that pious individual, the righteous individual,
إن يتقوى على طاعة الله عز وجل من هذا الطعام الذي طعم منك,
is going to strengthen himself with the food that he ate alongside you in order to worship Allah.
وكذلك,
and likewise, the Sheikh says,
إذا دخل إلى بيتك المؤمن,
if a believer, when a believer enters your house,
فإنه لا ينظر إلى ما لا ترغب,
he will not look at those things that you don't, that you are not pleased with him to look at.
فإنه يغض البصر.
He will lower his gaze.
لكن إن لم يكن تقياً,
yet if a person is not pious and righteous,
فإنه قد يسترق النظر إلى بيتك.
Rather that case, he may start trying to sneak glances in your house.
أما المؤمن لو رأى شيئاً,
as for the believer, if he was to see something,
فإنه يستره.
He would hide it.
وأما الفاجر فإنه يفضحه.
And as for the sinner, and he would openly start mentioning it to people.
فينبغي اختيار الصاحب.
So therefore, it's important to choose a good companion.
فالرجل على دين خليله.
For a person is judged according to his companionship.
فلينظر أحدكم من يخالف.
So each one of you should look at who his companion is.
أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And this is a wording similar to that which the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said.
ومثل الجليس الصالح والجليس السوء.
And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also said the example of a good companion and an evil companion.
كحامل المسك ونافخ الكير.
Is similar to a person who sells perfume and another one who is a blacksmith.
فينبغي لك اختيار الصاحب.
So therefore, it is upon you to choose a good companion.
وكذلك الجلوس على الطعام.
And likewise, sitting together to eat,
فيه من المودة والألفة.
It brings a sense of closeness and love.
فإن كان صاحب بدعة أو صاحب هوى,
so if the person with you was a person of despised religious innovation or a person of desires,
وخرجت معه ودخلت معه وأكلت معه,
and you were hanging around with him, going and coming with him and eating,
فإنه سيكون بينكم الألفة والمودة.
There would be some development of love and affection between you.
فقد يدخل عليك من الشبه.
And that person may cause doubts to enter into your mind.
وإلا فالسلف.
And the Salaf, however,
كانوا لا يجلسون مع أهل الأهواء والبدع.
They would never allow themselves to sit with the people of desires and the people of despised religious innovation.
بل إن بعضهم,
rather some of them,
كان يضع يديه في أذنيه,
would even place their hand, their fingers in their ears,
لا يستمع لهم حتى في قراءة القرآن,
so as not to listen to what the people of bid'ah would be saying, even if they were reciting Quran.
لأن الشبه خطافة.
Because doubts are another. What would you say to that, khattafa? Because they snatch you and they allure you. They are alluring.
فإذا دخلت في القلب,
and if they were to enter your heart,
قد لا تخرج.
They may never depart.
ومن ثمرات الأخوة,
and from the fruits of brotherhood,
مغفرة الذنوب,
is that your sins are forgiven.
لأن إذا اجتمع الأخوة والأصحاب والمتحابين في الله عز وجل,
for when brothers and good companions and those who come together for the sake of Allah, they who love each other for the sake of Allah, when they come together,
في مجالس الذكر,
in the gatherings of remembrance of Allah, for example,
وأسأل الله أن يكون هذا المجلس منها,
and we ask Allah to make this gathering one of those types of gatherings,
فإن الله عز وجل يسأل الملائكة وهو أعلم.
And Allah asks, then Allah asks the angels, though he knows best,
عن عباده,
about his slaves and servants.
وفي الحديث,
and in this hadith,
عن الملائكة قالوا يذكرون الجنة أو يستعيذون من النار,
that the angels say they are mentioning paradise and they are seeking protection from the hellfire.
وفي الحديث,
And in the same hadith,
أن الله عز وجل قال,
Allah Ta'ala says,
فَأُشْهِدُ فَإِنِّي أُشْهِدُكُمْ أَنِّي قَدْ غَفَرْتُ لَهُمْ
I take you as my witnesses that I have forgiven them their sins.
فهذه ثمرة من ثمرات الأخوة في الله.
So this is one of the fruits of brotherhood for the sake of Allah.
لأن الاجتماع يكون على ذكر الله عز وجل.
Because gathering together would be in order to remember Allah عز وجل.
فيكون فيها المغفرة.
So that would bring about forgiveness and mercy from Allah.
وكذلك من الثمرات الطمأنينة والسعادة في القلوب.
And also peace and happiness in the hearts is one of the fruits.
كذلك من ثمرات رفع الإيمان.
And also from the fruits is that iman is increased.
وتعلمون أن الإيمان يزيد بالطاعة.
And as you know, iman increases through obedience of Allah.
وينقص بالمعصية.
And decreases through disobedience of Allah.
فعندما تجلس مع إخوانك.
So when you sit with your brothers.
وتتذاكرون الله عز وجل.
Remembering Allah and reminding each other of Allah.
أو تقرؤون في كتب العلم.
Or reading in the books of knowledge.
فإن الإيمان يزداد.
And your iman, your faith will increase.
وكذلك من الثمرات.
From the fruits also.
أنه أن الأخوة في الله عز وجل.
That brotherhood for the sake of Allah عز وجل.
تكون سببا من عدم الانحراف.
Would be a means and a cause of not going astray.
الانحراف عن الطريق الحق.
Meaning not departing from the true straight path.
لأنه إن حدث شيئا فإن الإخوة يتناصحون فيما بينهم.
For if any event occurs and mistakes happen, brothers, they begin to advise each other.
ويعودون فيما بعض إلى ويعودون إلى كلام العلماء.
And they return back to the advice and the statements of the people of knowledge.
وإلى نصائح العلماء.
And to their advice.
فليحذر المسلم.
So a Muslim must be wary.
من خطوات الشيطان.
From the steps of the shaitan.
لأنه قد يأتي إليه فيسحبه فيكون وحيدا.
For the shaitan may come and cause a person to single himself out and remain alone.
فيقول أنا سأقرأ في الكتب في البيت.
And the person therefore starts saying, I will suffice myself with reading.
وسألخص بعض الفوائد في البيت.
I will start to suffice myself with reading in my own house and start to note down points of benefit while I'm at home.
فلا يخرج إلى إخوانه.
And therefore he doesn't mix with his brothers.
بل إن الشيطان قد يسحبه حتى عن مجالس العلم.
And the shaitan may cause that person to remain aloof and distant from the gatherings of knowledge.
وقد يقول له إنك لا تفهم هذا الدرس.
And he may whisper to that person saying, you will not understand this lesson, so do not attend it.
وهذا والله خطأ.
The sheikh says, this by Allah is a great mistake.
بل إن لم تفهم الدرس فإنك قد استفدت من بركة المجلس.
The Sheikh says, even if you were not to understand that lesson, at least you would benefit from the blessings of that gathering.
يكفيك إن انطلقت إلى مجالس العلم.
The Sheikh says, it's sufficient that if you went out to the circles of knowledge,
أن الملائكة تضع لك الأجنحة.
That the angels lower their wings for you.
رضا بما تصنع.
Out of pleasure of that which you're doing.
وهذه لا تضعها لأي أحد.
And they don't lower their wings for any ordinary person.
لا للملائكة لا للملوك ولا للأمراء ولا للتجار.
They don't do it not for kings, princes, leaders or businessmen.
إنما لطلاب العلم.
Rather they do it for the students and for the seekers of knowledge.
عندما تحضر مجالس العلم.
When you gather in the circles of knowledge.
فإنك ممن تحفهم الملائكة.
You are from those who are surrounded and engulfed by the angels.
فقد كنت في مجلس فيه من الملائكة.
You are therefore in a gathering where angels attended.
وهذه من نعمة الله عز وجل.
And this is from the great blessings of Allah عز وجل.
وطالب العلم.
And the student of knowledge.
عليه أن يحمد الله عز وجل.
Must praise Allah the mighty and majestic.
ويشكره.
And thank him.
أن وفقه الله عز وجل إلى هذا الطريق.
That he guided him and granted him that success to tread this path.
فكم من شخص قد حرم من مجالس العلم.
For how many people were prevented from these gatherings of knowledge.
وقد اختارك الله عز وجل أن تكون ممن يحضر هذه المجالس.
Yet Allah selected you to gather these gatherings, to attend these gatherings.
فهذه نعمة.
For this is a blessing.
ينبغي الشكر عليها.
That deserves thanks.
وينبغي الجد والاجتهاد.
And therefore a person must strive hard.
في حفظ العلم.
In memorizing knowledge.
وفي كتابته.
And writing it down.
وفي مراجعته.
And revising it regularly.
ثم بعد ذلك.
And after that.
تطبقه على نفسك.
Acting upon it.
ثم بعد ذلك.
And following that.
تعلم غيرك.
Begin to teach others.
والدعوة اليوم.
دعوة today.
إلى الله عز وجل.
To Allah عز وجل.
قد تسهلت.
Has become very easy.
فقد تدعو إلى الله في جميع أنحاء العالم وأنت في بيتك.
You might be able to call to Allah all over the world while you are sitting in your own house.
والناس بحاجة إلى الدعوة إلى التوحيد.
And the people are in dire need to be called to التوحيد.
فإنك قد تجد شخصا.
For you might find a person
يحفظ القرآن.
Who has memorized the whole Quran.
ويقوم الليل.
And he stands in the night praying.
ولكنه يدعو القبور الأضرحة.
Yet he calls upon the dead in their graves.
أو يطوف عليها.
Or he performs tawaf of the graves.
أو يقول مدد يا رسول الله.
Or he says, O Messenger of Allah, save me and help me.
أو يذبح لغير الله.
Or he may sacrifice an animal for other than Allah.
وهذا والله لا ينفعه.
And by Allah, this is something that will not benefit him.
لو صلى وصام وقام وهو مشرك.
If he was to stand in prayer and to fast and to do various acts of worship while he is upon shirk
ومات على ذلك,
and died upon that,
فإنه قد يكون من الخالدين في نار جهنم.
This person could be from those who are eternal in the hellfire of hell.
ولعلي أكتفي بهذا.
And I will suffice myself with this, inshallah.
وأنا قلت في بداية الكلمة.
And I said at the beginning.
أن ما حضرنا إلا أن نستفيد أيضا من الشيخ وليد.
We only attended to benefit from Sheikh.
ولكن قلت نتدارس فيما بيننا إلى أن يأتي الشيخ وهو قد حضر.
And Sheikh Waleed has arrived, so we will stop there and invite the Sheikh. تفضل شيخنا.
جزاكم الله خير على حسن استماعكم.
May Allah reward you all for your good manners in listening.
وأسأل الله أن يكون هذا العمل خالصا لوجهه الكريم.
And I ask Allah Ta'ala that He makes this action purely for His sake.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. جزاكم الله خير شيخنا.